When astronauts travel into space, the fluids shift upward, and it's believed to increase intracranial pressure and lead to vision problems. So the goal of our project is to test one of the mechanisms that's believed to be responsible for the increase in intracranial pressure. Specifically, we're looking at venous congestion and how that can cause a backup that increases the pressure inside the skull.
This all started when I got an email from NASA, which gave us information on an opportunity to fly on parabolic flight. So it's students that have to compete with their proposal and their outreach program in order to have the opportunity to fly on the parabolic flight out of Houston, Texas.
We had only 3 or 4 days to submit a proposal. Given that amount of short of time, we hesitated. We thought that it would be difficult, but we also knew that this was once in a lifetime opportunity that we would that we could not miss. So we worked through the weekend. We stayed up long overnight hours and put the proposal together.
Outreach was a very important part of the proposal. So along with submitting a proposal for our experiment, we also had to submit a separate solid outreach plan. One of those involves going to K through 12 schools. We designed several activities. We had a tilt table and we would strap the kids in and tilt them upside down, give them a sense of what those headward fluid shifts feel like.
It was a very interesting opportunity, so I decided to get on board, and I started off as their electronics guy because I have a background in electronics engineering. And we did a little bit of research and quickly found out that we were probably going to be working on the model either in the lab over there or here at my garage. So we moved to this garage where we had some tools to work with.
My role in this project was helping with the piping system and structural design of the frame. We have a pump which will mimic the heart. It's the power for the system. We'll go up the artery and to the top of the brain chamber. Through the brain chamber, there's a compliant tube which can expand and contract, and it moves around so it can expand with lower pressure or higher pressure. You can then go across and to the right, going down the bottom, is a jugular replica where that also can collapse. At the very bottom is a reservoir chamber where any excess fluid from the previous tubes collapsing or expanding can accumulate there and not affect the overall pressure everywhere else.
So when we travel to Johnson Space Center, we'll have actually 2 days of parabolic flights. During the flight itself, our mechanical model is connected to a software that measures the data continuously, and we are trying to make it as automated as possible. So during the parabolic flight, we have minor adjustments to the model. Another reason for having the system run practically by itself is the worry of getting sick during the flight.
Even if I get sick and throw up all over the place on the plane, I'm still gonna have a great time and really love the experience.